"The left," said Miss Lavendar, with a hesitating glance at her tea table. Then she exclaimed, as if in a sudden little burst of resolution, "But, oh, won't you stay and have tea with me? Please do. Mr. Kimball's will have tea over before you get there, and Charlotta the Fourth and I will be so glad to have you." Diana looked mute inquiry at Anne. "We'd like to stay," said Anne promptly, for she had made up her mind that she wanted to know more of this surprising Miss Lavendar, "if it won't inconvenience you. But you are expecting other guests, aren't you?" Miss Lavendar looked at her tea table again and blushed. "I know you'll think me dreadfully foolish," she said. "I am foolish, and I am ashamed of it when I'm found out, but never unless I am found out. I'm not expecting anybody. I was just pretending I was. You see, I was so lonely. I love company. That is, the right kind of company. But so few people ever come here because it is so far out of the way. Charlotta the Fourth was lonely, too, so I just pretended I was going to have a tea party. I cooked for it, and decorated the table for it, and set it with my mother's wedding china. And I dressed up for it." Diana secretly thought Miss Lavendar quite as peculiar as report had pictured her. The idea of a woman of 45 playing at having a tea party just as if she were a little girl. But Anne of the shining eyes exclaimed joyfully, "Oh, do you imagine things too?" That too revealed a kindred spirit to Miss Lavendar. "Yes, I do," she confessed boldly. "Of course it's silly in anybody as old as I am. But what is the use of being an independent old maid if you can't be silly when you want to, and when it doesn't hurt anybody? A person must have some compensations. I don't believe I could live at times if I didn't pretend things. I'm not often caught at it, though, and Charlotta the Fourth never tells. But I'm glad to be caught today, for you have really come, and I have tea all ready for you. Will you go up to the spare room and take off your hats? It's the white door at the head of the stairs. I must run out to the kitchen and see that Charlotta the Fourth isn't letting the tea boil. Charlotta the Fourth is a very good girl, but she will let the tea boil." Miss Lavendar tripped off to the kitchen on hospitable thoughts intent, and the girls found their way up to the spare room, an apartment as white as its door, lighted by the ivy-hung dormer window and looking, as Anne said, like the place where happy dreams grew. "This is quite an adventure, isn't it?" said Diana. "And isn't Miss Lavendar sweet, if she is a little odd? She doesn't look a bit like an old maid." "She looks just as music sounds, I think," answered Anne.